What school are you going to?
Corcoran.
Are you really?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty cool. I know you see a lot of artsy fartsy people up in there. My name is Noah Franklin Williams, born 1980, May 28th. My occupation, I work for Arlington County Government, my day job.
Mm-hmm.
But then I'm like a mad scientist in a dungeon in the afternoon creating these pieces.
Oh, yeah.
I knew, I've been art since I was a little kid. Pretty much since I was 5 years old, I knew I was gonna be an artist. You know, I was that kid that was always drawing on the walls and on the desk, writing stuff and drawing little cartoons and getting in trouble for that and writing on the bathroom walls and graduated to spray paint. But not anymore though. My imagination is kind of wild. So, you know, I'm constantly all day long thinking about art and what I could, materials I could use, or, you know, fantasizing, working on my piece right now. Like, mm-hmm. What else can I add to it that's going to really set it apart from everybody else? You know, a lot of times people donate certain materials,
mm-hmm.
and dumpster diving, hunting construction zones down,
nice.
Looking for scrap materials, you know. You know, I kind of stumbled on, you know, working with metal and sculptures because, you know, it'd be a lot of times where, you know, I like to paint too, but, you know, I can't afford to buy the paints all the time. So I was like, you know what? Let me use something that I can never run out of.
Mm-hmm.
Other people's junk. Who came to see that you wrote? Right now, that the metal and the wood and, just the materials that I find, man. I just been more intrigued with that. I still love to paint.
Mm-hmm.
Not planning on doing some stuff down the line, but right now this is where I'm gonna stick with this for a while. I got a couple artists that I like. There was a brother that was he was from around this area. A guy named Big Al Johnson. I really liked his artwork. His artwork was really different. Come alive. What happened to your conscience as it died? You know, you just keep on putting out there, and sometimes you get in and sometimes you don't. You know, when you have a passion towards something and you've already, you know, put it in your head where you're going to be, there's nothing that's going to stop you. You know, you might have situations where, you know, you might not get accepted into every show. You're not going to get every last mm-hmm. one of them. But, you know, you just make sure when you do have it that your stuff is sticking with people's heads. You know, they remember.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, that's the dude that did such and such. Can't you see me that the nation is about to capsize? Here and there, not enough. I need some people to spend some money.
The reality of an artist.
Yeah. But, you know what I mean? It's, you know, it's... You gotta have a love for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I look at it like this. You know, it's a blessing and a curse at the same time, because people don't understand that hunger and that passion towards something if they don't have that. And you know, sometimes it can become obsessive. You know what I mean? You get so caught up, and I'm in that point. I'm in the zone right now. You know, I'm in that point where I don't want to be bothered with nobody. I just want to be in my dungeon and create. Tell me why you're killing our woman and our children. Not really. I mean, I still doodle around a lot, even though, you know, to me it might just be scribble scrabble, but it's always future ideas or future projects and stuff, something that I could kind of go back on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I got a tendency sometimes I gotta like focus on one thing, or I'll be doing like a million projects at one time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I try to just focus on one. Your brothers and your sisters, you condemn them. Your mother and your... Just don't allow anybody to tell you that you're wasting your time. If it's, like I said, I've had this love since I was a little kid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've always known this is what I was put on this planet to do. You know, every time I've tried to veer off and do something else, like, oh, I'm going to do this, it never worked out. But when I put my energy into this 100%, I see how the universe blessed me in return. So I got to continue to just feed that, you know what I mean? And, you know, you get to a point where, you know, it's like, you know, I enjoy this feeling. I like working on my art. It's my meditation time. You know, I play music. Sometimes I don't have no music at all. I just work in silence. Throughout the years, I've had my stuff shown in a couple, you know, multiple places. Down at the Torpedo Factory at the Art League. I've been doing my thing down there for a while. At the Washington Sculpture, it was a, they had it set up in an area where they had it like on display. It wasn't really like a gallery. It was a gallery in Georgetown I showed my artwork at. Then the Washington Times building, I had a showing there. Why? Tell me why you be like it. I think so. I definitely, you know, with a lot of my pieces, you know, I feel that it's, you know, it's definitely a connection. You know, I have that African spirit in me strong. And I'm not ashamed of it either, you know what I mean? That's mm-hmm. I could just say that, you know, that's one thing that my mother always instilled in my brother and myself, you know. This is who we are. And I look at it like this, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter, you know, if you fair skin like myself, you know, we know our family, you know, we got a lot of mixture in our family. You black, you black. Yes, my mother. And my mother, she knew at her, you know, she saw it at an early age that I had an interest. And, you know, she kind of, you know, had me involved in classes and stuff at a young age and exposed me to different art classes and stuff. And just kind of grew from that. I used to work at Safeway back in the day. Mm-hmm. I always was, you know, I always worked. You know, I had that job for what, like 5 years? And then when I had my first son, I was like, man, I gotta make some more money than this. So I started working at a trash company. That job sucked. Kept that for a while. Went to another job doing trash. And I don't know whoever came up with that line saying trash men make money, but that's a goddamn lie. But did that, and then just stuck with the county and just kind of moved up through the ranks. You know, just kept on applying for positions and moved up. You know, sometimes I teach classes. Lately, the classes I was teaching were like recycled materials, using like water bottles and stuff like that. I had got a bunch of pipe cleaners, and we were making like African instruments and stuff. But I usually, lately it's been kids. I do adults too. I haven't did an adult class in a while. I definitely would like to see myself in, you know, my work in different galleries, and, you know, I would really like to shoot my shot at the Visionary Art Museum of Baltimore. I really think my art would fit very well with what they have there. But I'm looking like this, the sky's the limit, you know what I mean? I'm trying to take it to that level of, you know, my pieces are in history books, you know what I mean? Somebody's learning about me in the future. This is how much I love this, you know what I mean? I plan on, you know, this is what I'm gonna do. And nobody's gonna push me otherwise, you know what I mean? I've already made my mind up. I've already asked the universe, so you know what I mean? I can't renege on my part now, you know what I'm saying? I got to do what I got to do to follow through. Mm-hmm. And as long as you feeding that, you're gonna get blessings in return. You know, it's, I look at it like this, man. You put 100% into whatever your passion is. There's no way you can fail. And then we've got so much to do. Stop the killing of our women and our children. Your brothers and your sisters, don't condemn them. Your mother and your father, you